Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AMMO Wrestling. Tonight, we present our third pay-per-view, Kill the Lights. It'll be an incredible night. We are crowning tag team champions here tonight. Women's champions here tonight. We could have a new world champion here tonight. But we're starting it out with the last hero himself. We're starting it out with Leon Stark. He's looking to get some momentum gained here tonight. He hasn't had the best record as of late. Well, he's looking to change that. Will he be able to accomplish that goal here tonight? His opponent, someone else who has not really had a great record, hasn't been able to get the ball rolling thus far. It's Tyler Dawn, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, he was in the world title tournament, lost to the eventual winner. Tyler Dawn's been here since day one. And well, he's still trying to gain that momentum, get the ball rolling, trying to win some titles, trying to prove himself here. He's one of the lower guys in the card, and he wants to be getting that big pay, like the main eventers do, like the world champions do. He wants to rise up the card, but right now he's fallen, and one of these guys is going to rise tonight, and one of them is going to fall. That's just simple. That's how it goes in wrestling and in life, really. We'll see who is able to pull out the victory here tonight and rise up the ranks. Who's going to fall back down into that dreaded lower mid card? This match should be an incredible one, ladies and gentlemen. I can't wait to get it started in just a few moments. All right, well, it's Leon Stark, and it's Tyler Dawn. Bell sounds, match is underway. Leon Stark coming out the gate with a strike and a Hurricane Rana, sending Tyler Dawn to his back on a prone position. That is not where you want to be in the early stages of a match. Now Leon Stark pulling out the moonsault immediately here, going for the cover, not even a one count. Oh, but Tyler Dawn coming at him with a super kick. Kicks him in the face, sends him to the ground. And now he's looking for something there, but wasn't able to hit it. Leon Stark measured it and countered. And well, now a DDT planting Leon Stark on the neck. Thus far, it's been a very even encounter. Only been a couple seconds, though. A lot of action in just a minute. Tyler Dawn trying to position him. Trying to rain down some strikes, Leon Stark. Looking for an enziguri, misses. Into the corner goes Tyler Dawn. And a springboard Hurricane Rana there by Leon Stark. Incredible maneuver. Well, now he's got him with the Salida del Sol. A backflip DDT. And another big Hurricane Rana. The back's got to be feeling the pressure here. Going to take a toll. And, well, a DDT. And, well, backstory behind this match, we're told, is Leon Stark was attacked a couple weeks ago by a mass assailant. And, well, he's trying to figure that out. He's trying to also gain momentum. He's interrogating Tyler Dawn. He's interrogating the entire locker room, trying to figure out who attacked him. And now, with the octopus stretch locked in, Tyler Dawn able to get out of it. Like I said, he's been interrogating the entire locker room. He wants answers, and he wants them now. as Tyler Dawn nails a big drop kick and now trying to get himself fired up here. Leon Stark having to use the ropes to pull himself up to his feet to tie up. Leon Stark able to get the better of it with another Hurricane Rana. I believe that is the third, maybe fourth Hurricane Rana that has been nailed here tonight. And it ends a gurry to the side of the head. Surprised the ear isn't bleeding now. Tyler Dawn rolls out of the ring but gets right back in. And now Leon Stark back in the ring as well. Off the ropes he goes. Could have been going for a stun gun-like maneuver there. Now positions him in the corner, putting him on the top rope. Now, but Leon Stark coming with a big kick. And a bulldog there. Shouts out to Rey Mysterio with that bulldog. Now dragging Tyler Dawn, putting him on the ropes. What is he looking for here? Clothesline out of the ring. He's not going to do this. He's not. We got a flying superhero. The Superman plancha to the outside. A fitting maneuver for Leon Stark. As well now, these two wrestle on the outside. Referee warning them to get back into the ring. They are not heeding his warning, however, as a backflip. I wouldn't be worrying too much about taunting your opponent right now. I would worry about winning the match, but what do I know? I've never been a wrestler. Now another Hurricane Rana. This time delivered by Tyler Dawn. Seven count here. Leon Stark back into the ring. Tyler Dawn catches him with a Saito suplex. And well, like I said a second ago, what applies for one applies for the other. I'd be worrying about winning this match, not showing off to the crowd, Tyler Dawn. Well, now both of these men just trying to confuse the other one, it looks like, but Tyler Dawn just tripping up Leon Stark, sweeping the leg. And now a big knee sends Leon Stark crumbling to the ground. But Leon Stark throwing him into the steel steps. And now trying to get the fans on his side. But now Tyler Dawn throwing him into the steel stairs. Five count now. Six. Once again into the stairs goes Leon Stark. Seven. Now throwing across the arena here. These guys need to get back into the ring. And as soon as I say that, they listened. Tyler Dawn now trying to gain the advantage, trying to get the win here. And for some, but Leon moved out of the way. And a super kick and another. The big warning shot by Leon Stark. And is that enough to get the victory? Yes, it is. Leon Stark getting a very needed victory for himself here tonight. He needed this one real bad. This is going to be a big momentum booster, hopefully a turning point for him going into his future here at AMO Wrestling. We'll see what kind of effects this win has in the immediate and the far future. But for tonight, he gets to celebrate. He is the winner in our opening contest here at Kill the Lights. It is Leon Stark, ladies and gentlemen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for women's action. Our first women's match of the night. And well, it's definitely two different styles going at it right now. Our first competitor, Vanessa Spencer, she definitely employs an MMA wrestling hybrid style. You see she's wearing an MMA-like gear. And while, yes, she is a great MMA performer, I'd have to say she's an even better wrestler. Well, she's trying to get a big win here tonight. Trying to prove she belongs here in AMMO Wrestling. Trying to prove she belongs in the women's title picture here in AMMO Wrestling. And well, one of our signature AMMO pay-per-views. There's no better place to do it than here. We'll see what she can do here tonight against her opponent coming out real soon. And well, she has a very daunting task in front of her here tonight. One of the three women in our first ever women's match in AMMO Wrestling at Going the Social Distance. It's Lydia Madison. And well, she hasn't had many matches since that first loss. That goes on her record at Going the Social Distance. Really, the same can be said for Vanessa Spencer. She hasn't had many matches here in AMMO Wrestling. And while both of these women trying to establish themselves in the women's division here, in the women's title picture here, we'll see in just a few moments who can come out on the better end of that discussion. All right, well, this match is now underway. Our second contest of the night, our first women's contest of the night. It's Vanessa Spencer and Lydia Madison. And now Madison coming out the gate with a bulldog. Lydia Madison going to implore a more wrestling style. She's going to go not for as many strikes and suplexes as we see one there by Vanessa Spencer. Kick there to the head. Legal in Pride, not legal in the UFC. But legal here in AMMO Wrestling. And a big gut buster. You gotta expect Vanessa Spencer to use more of her fists, more of her feet. Implore more throws, suplexes, punches, kicks than Lydia Madison. Well, as you see there with a big face buster. And now a Hurricane Rana sending Vanessa Spencer to her back. Snapmare and a kick to the back. Vanessa Spencer right back up there with a clothesline. Almost like a face plant clothesline. Now stalking her. Now turns her around. What she's looking for here is a knee and a clothesline. A devastating knee and then a discus clothesline. Well, now Lydia Madison getting out of the ring, trying to look for a safe haven, trying to run away. Oh, but Vanessa Spencer follows her right back into the ring. And now she's got her up. Slams her on the turnbuckle and just throws her. Savage maneuver there. Now going for some more big strikes. Sending Lydia Madison crumbling to the ground and going for the cover now. Two. Only a two count. I'm surprised she didn't get a three count there. Those strikes are devastating. And now what's she looking for? Oh my gosh. Just like a follow through knee strike. Two. My lord, the resilience of Lydia Madison. I have to commend it. Those are some big knees, some big strikes. I'm surprised she's able to still breathe, let alone fight in this contest. And now another bulldog. pulling her to the center of the ring now. And now I think she's looking for that big knee and clothesline again. Turns her around. There's the knee and the clothesline. Well, now picking her up, not even going for the cover. Went for a kick. Lydia able to move, but just picks her right back up and plants her with authority once again. Well, now an inverted angle slam, an incredible maneuver there. Speaking of great crossover athletes, you want to be a great one? Use the greatest crossover athlete in wrestling history's move, I guess. Make it your own, and that's exactly what Vanessa Spencer did. We're now just raking the eyes. Lydia Madison off the ropes and just nails her with a boot. Right of the cheekbone. Might have shattered that cheekbone. Now going for the cover. One, not even a one count. Didn't even get a one count. Vanessa Spencer's been getting two counts mostly all night. And oh my gosh, a big elbow. Now going for the cover once again. One, only a one count, not even a two count. Well, Lydia Madison probably wondering what she's got to do, and well, she's going to the high risk, high reward. She's going to the high rent district. Now calling for Vanessa Spencer to get up. What is she looking for here? Almost like a front flip drop kick, and going for the cover. One, two, three, no. Only two. Referee motions for only a two count, and this match continues. Lydia Madison now trying to get a breather, take a chance to get the crowd on her side. And we're now stringing together some big moves, double clotheslines, and a drop kick. Vanessa Spencer now, she had Lydia Madison on the ropes for the first half. Right now she's on the ropes herself. Gonna have to fight to get back into this one. And another big elbow strike. Pulling her to the center of the ring once more, going for the cover again. We got the one, only a one count. Everything Lydia Madison has done has not been able to get a two count so far out of Vanessa Spencer. Let me tell you, Vanessa Spencer's a fighter. You gotta be, if you wanna be a crossover athlete. It's tough to transition from one sport to another. That's exactly what she's trying to do here in Ammo Wrestling. And another big front flip drop kick. Now going for the cover. Is that enough to put her away? One, two, three, and it is. A shock victory out of that. That big front flip drop kick by Lydia Madison, able to get the job done here tonight. Vanessa Spencer came out of the gate real quick, real fast. Strung together a lot of big moves, a lot of big strikes. Weren't able to get the job done. And well, Lydia Madison, she kept on fighting. She stayed in there. Two drop kicks from the top rope later. And she is your winner here tonight. You see here the one, the two, and the three. Able to get that big win as she moves up in the women's title rankings. I wouldn't be surprised if you see Lydia Madison challenging for that women's title anytime soon. We'll see what the future holds for her in the coming weeks on Ammo Wrestling. And now we transition back from women's action to men's action. A fairly newcomer here to Ammo Wrestling. This is Vernon Quinn. Had a successful debut on episode 11. And well, he's looking to continue that wave of momentum. you know that's unheard of. And if anyone can do it, it's Vernon Quinn. But he's got a tough opponent here tonight. And we'll see what he can do. I see myself in the pistol smoke, fool. I'm the kind of G the little homies wanna be like, on my knees in the night, saying prayers in the street light. Been spending most of the night, filling in the desk is And well, ladies and gentlemen, I need to correct myself. I said this was singles action. It is, in fact, a triple threat match. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is Ichi. And while I don't know much about Ichi, you can tell by his sheer size and presence, he's a force to be reckoned with here in AMMO Wrestling. Well, what better place to make your debut than here at Kill the Lights? And Ichi, he's looking to make a successful one here tonight. This man, he's very big. He's very commanding. Whenever he walked out from the entranceway, the room here kind of got silent. A lot of the fans went quiet, just, I don't know, out of respect or fear, I don't know. Well, Ichi, he's ready for this match. Whoa. Our third competitor also making his debut here tonight. He's got an interesting look, that's for sure. It's Chandler Finch. You can tell just by looking at him. He's got a personality. And it's a fun one. We'll see if that can translate into the ring. And if he can keep having fun when he's in the ring with Ichi and Vernon Quinn. We'll see what he can do here tonight in just a few moments as this match begins. And well, all three competitors looking ready. Here is Ichi grabbing Vernon Quinn immediately, hoists him up. Could he be looking for a razor's edge here? He nails it! Immediately just throwing him. And well, now, oh my gosh! Just putting Chandler Finch on his butt. And well, now Vernon Quinn trying to take him on. He's taunting him. Throws him in the corner and taunts him, but now Finch and Quinn going at it, and will Quinn? I thought he might be in trouble there. Finch went for the early pinfall, and will Ichi, he's got him up with a brain buster. Dude, Ichi has to be at least double the size of both of these men. It looks like if Vernon Quinn and Chandler Finch, if they teamed up, they might stand a chance here tonight. And we're now Ichi off the ropes with a big kick to the face. And we're now a Hurricane Rana surprisingly taking Ichi off his feet. Pulling him to the center of the ring now. He's got him up. Swinging neck breaker. Kick to the back. And a drop kick by Vernon Quinn. These two need to be teaming up on Ichi right now. He's down. Go after him, not each other. He's the biggest threat in this match right now. And well, now Chandler Finch trying to go after him. Ishii able to get out of the way and now going for the cover. Man, I cannot get over the size of Ishii. This is such a big man. He looks like he could literally eat both of his competitors in the ring tonight. And well, now Vernon Quinn, the big knockout shot, and Ishii with one of his own. Just a big forearm to the face. Now Snapmare once again off the ropes and another big boot. Chandler Finch having to use the ropes to stay up here. And well, now Ishii just jumps right on top of him and raining down punches. Now Vernon Quinn able to get him down and go for the cover. Referee not in position. It's a one count, but Ishii able to power out. Vernon now with a face buster. And now going for the cover once again. One, two, no. Only a two count. Now Ishii getting right back up to his feet. Finch able to knock him into the corner somehow. And what in the world is he doing here? What is he doing? He has got him on the top rope. And oh my god! Ishii and Chandler Finch going for the ride of a century. A top rope Spanish fly. And well, Vernon Quinn going for the cover. Finch able to break it up, but now Vernon Quinn, he's got the guillotine choke on Finch. Able to break out of it, though. Looked like he was going for the cover there, but gave it up. Now dragging Quinn onto the ropes. What's he looking for here? Oh, my gosh. Just pulls him into the ropes like a decapacitator there. And some chops, oh my god, and a clothesline. I don't want to know what it feels like to be chopped by Ishii, or hit with any move by Ishii, for a matter of fact. Well, now Vernon Quinn able to get back into the ring. And, well, you shouldn't have took time to taunt there. You should have went right after Ishii. And well, now got them both in a corner. Now, what is he looking for? Dragging Vernon back into the corner, but Vernon punching his way out of it. And now a knee to the head, knocking Ishii off of his feet. Ishii rolls out of the ring. And a drop kick by Finch now, trying to get on the offensive. And now just some shots. Some big shots there on to Vernon Quinn. Now Finch going to the top rope. Looking for a big splash, but Vernon Quinn was able to get his knees up. And now just raking the face. Ishii back in the ring. What is he looking for? Went for like a suplex almost, but Vernon Quinn able to take him down and raining down punches. Impressive by Vernon Quinn, able to go after that big base and take Ishii down. And well, now he's got that guillotine lock in on him. Finch breaking it up. But Quinn could be looking for the cover. Yes, he is. One. Finch breaks that up as well. And well, now Vernon Quinn with a big combination there. A bionic elbow. Is that enough for the victory? No. Just a two count. And Chandler Finch right back up. And he takes a bump. And he pays for it there. Finch with a knee to the stomach. And a Hurricane Rana. Now it looks like he's going after Ishii. Pulling him back to his base. And a drop kick. And another. Went for a clothesline and a cross body. Chandler Finch looking for something here. Throws him out of the ring. Onto the floor. He's telling the fans he knows what he's doing, sliding out of the ring. Oh, but Ichi able to get his wherewithal about him, throwing Chandler Finch back into the ring. And a DDT by Ichi. And what is he doing here? Oh, my God. He's dead. He's dead. He's got to be dead. He just had a gigantic man jump on him. And no, not this, not this. Burning hammer. A burning hammer by Ichi. And that's got to be enough to put this match away. One, two, three. And surprising no one, in this triple threat match, Ichi is your winner here tonight. Both of these guys, they fought hard. They really did. Vernon Quinn, Chandler Finch, they both fought very hard. But the sheer stature of Ichi, the power of Ichi, just incredible. Just able to overpower both men to get the victory. And there you see him. He is your winner. It is Ichi. And I expect a lot to come out of this win for him and in the future of AMO Wrestling for Ichi. And well, now, ladies and gentlemen, we do move back to singles competition with two incredible performers here in AMO Wrestling. To start us out, you know him. You either love him or you hate him. It's Deshaun Romero. He looks to torment someone else here tonight, in specific. He looks to torment Andy Garrett here tonight. And well, Deshaun Romero, he hasn't got many wins here in AMO Wrestling, but I don't think he really cares either. I think he just wants to hurt people. I think he just wants to have a good match and destroy his opponents. Win or lose, I think as long as he's on the offensive and hurting people, I think he's happy. Well, we'll see if he's able to come out on the happy side here tonight. And if he's able to come out on the winning side as well. And his opponent here tonight, accompanied to the ring by Ring Rust, it is Andy Garrett. These three men having a shared a common goal, I should say. They're wanting to win. All three of these men, they haven't really been on the best momentum streaks, I would say. They've been losing quite a bit, all three of them. Well, they're trying to snap that streak here tonight. And Andy Garrett, he's trying to take on Deshaun Romero, which is no easy task. Well, we'll see what he can do, but Sean Romero is an incredible performer, but so is Andy Garrett. We'll see who's able to come out on the better side of this encounter here tonight. And you got to believe the two men accompanying Andy Garrett, Ring Rust, they're going to, you guarantee, you take it from me, they're going to come into play in this match. Whether it's a distraction, whether it's a blatant interference, whether it's just looking at Deshaun Romero the wrong way and having him look over his shoulder, they're going to play a part in this match. No question about it. The only question is, will they have enough presence in this match to get Andy Garrett the win? We'll see in just a few moments if they will. And if Andy Garrett can come out on the winning side of the night here at Kill the Lights.
Corn liquor tastes sweeter in this town. Could it be it's the same as the last? I swear I've seen your face elsewhere before, just as familiar as a box.
And well, this match is underway. Deshaun Romero versus Andy Garrett with Ring Rust at ringside. Andy Garrett coming out with a big throw. The power of Andy Garrett for sure will come into play here tonight as a knee to the face. It's power versus technical prowess, in my opinion. And whoa, Deshaun Romero with a big power slam going for the cover. Only a one count. Like I said, it is power versus technical prowess as Deshaun Romero just kicking him in the forehead multiple times. I'm surprised he's not bleeding after that. And is he going for it again? Yes, he is. Just kicking him in the forehead. My God. Is he going for it again? Oh, my. This is brutal. Referee, get him off of him. Now, going for a drop kick, Andy Garrett. We're in the opening stages of this match, and he's already been punished. I think that was about 18 kicks to the head. Well, now, Sean Romero hanging up Andy Garrett, now kicking him in the gut, and Andy Garrett falling to the mat. Now, what's he looking for? Oh, he's biting the hand. Just biting the hand of Andy Garrett. What a sick man this Deshaun Romero is. He's crazy. He's a lunatic. He comes in and he destroys his opponents. Doesn't always win. Doesn't always lose. He's been about 50-50. But win or lose, we always see someone get hurt whenever Deshaun Romero is in the ring. We always see his opponent get hurt. And well, he's trying to do that to Andy Garrett right now, stretching him out and just stomps on the arm. Andy Garrett able to roll away. Kick to the gut now. He's looking for something, but Sean Romero breaking out of it. And a sling blade. Pulls him. Drags him to the center of the ring. Went for the cover, but a rope break. Now, Sean Romero got him again and just snaps the wrist. And a German, or excuse me, a full Nelson suplex, I should say. Now, going for that power slam one more time. Incredible maneuver. And once again, is he going for it again? No, this time he's got him up with the Steiner screwdriver. just dropping him right on his head and going for the cover, but a rope break once more. That big body of Andy Garrett, that tall body of Andy Garrett coming into play as he's able to stretch his leg out to get the rope break. Referee instructs Deshaun to break the pinfall, and now Andy Garrett getting on the offensive here. Ring rust, you can see, very happy on the outside. They're cheering on their fearless leader, I guess you could call him. Now Deshaun, he's got him and just drops him right on the knee and into the cover. One, two, three. No! Andy Garrett somehow able to kick out. I thought it was elementary. I thought Deshaun Romero won. I thought there wasn't a question about it, but Andy Garrett somehow finding a way to kick out. And a big knee drop there by Andy. And just kicking him in the back. Andy Garrett seems to have snapped as of late. Taking out Sebastian Ramos a couple weeks ago. Heinous attack. And we're now going for the cover. Only a two count. Sean Romero staying in this match. He's got to get on the offensive soon. As a big splash by Andy Garrett. Well, now he's looking for something. Calling for him to get up. He's got him up now. And a simple math. Is that enough to get the job done? One, two, no. Deshaun Romero somehow finding a way to kick out of the simple math. And now another hip press. Just putting that big body right on the back of Deshaun Romero. Romero now somehow finding a kick and an elbow to the face. And another suplex. And Deshaun Romero, he's freaking out. I would hate to see him when he is freaked out. If he's sane every other time we see him in the ring, I'd hate to see him freaked out. Oh, now Andy Garrett falling into the corner. Going for something there, but Andy Garrett able to catch him. Got his hand on the chest and just throws him to the ground. Impact of a meteor right there on a clothesline. Now, Andy Garrett looking for something, but nice karate throw by Romero. Now throwing him on the outside of the ring and following him out there. And will you see James Nelson coming, looking to provide a little bit of a distraction. Referee telling him to get away from Deshaun Romero, but he made a beeline for him. Now picking up Andy Garrett. Andy Garrett somehow finding a way to reverse that Irish whip. Now going to the outside of the ring. Sean Romero now back inside the ring as well as Andy Garrett. Romero to the outside. Romero back in. Able to get the advantage. Snapmare and a kick to the back, but Andy Garrett is right back up. And a clothesline in the corner. And now just choking him with his knee. A knee right on the throat, choking, trying to take the breath out of Sean Romero. Now going for the cover to... Only a two count there. Andy Garrett probably wondering what he's got to do to get the job done. Well, he went for something, but Romero able to slip through with some kicks to the leg. Elbow to the face now. And well, he's got him up. What's he looking for here? Death Valley Driver. Driving him right into the canvas and now pulling him to the center of the ring. Going for the cover. One, two, only a two count. Sean Romero, he's on the offensive right now. Andy Garrett is on the ropes. And what is he looking for here? Slits his throat and a big knee to the face. A gigantic knee right to the nose. And is that enough for the victory? Two. Yes, it is. Deshaun Romero getting a big victory here tonight. Should take him past 500 for his record here in Ammo Wrestling. What an incredible performance. That big knee to the face was enough to get the job done. Well, Andy Garrett, he just continues on his losing streak. You gotta think, with each passing loss, he gets angrier and angrier. Well, that anger can either be a motivator or a distraction. Right now, it seems to be a distraction. Well, you can definitely say Andy Garrett was hurt here tonight. You saw those big kicks right out the gate. But that wasn't even the end of it. Deshaun Romero getting the big victory here tonight. Well, there should be a lot brighter things in the future of this man coming very soon. And well, folks, it is time for the first of three big title matches taking place here tonight. We're starting with the tag team title ladder match. Three incredible teams going 2v2v2 to earn the tag team title. And our first team, Marcus Lawrence and Austin Oliver, the Carolina Connection, two incredible high school and college athletes, very young men with an incredible opportunity here tonight. And well, the first of their four opponents, team that made their debut on the last episode of Ammo Wrestling, it is Dion Yuri and Big Ramon. They're definitely the team with the least amount of experience in this match. And well, we'll see if that plays a factor in the results here tonight. They also, with the same incredible opportunity as the Carolina Connection, we'll see if they're able to capitalize on it. And we'll definitely... the favorite coming into tonight. Well, I say the favorite until that big injury to Sebastian Ramos by Andy Garrett. Sebastian Ramos is being replaced, and who by? Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is Luke Franklin. And it looks like he will be replacing Sebastian Ramos in this tag team title match here tonight. Well, right now my favorite, I would say, is the Carolina Connection. Well, they're the only team in the ring right now that's an actual team that has teamed multiple times in Ammo Wrestling and throughout the world. And while this match starts, it is Luke Franklin and Arthur Finch making up the team of Subway. It is Dion Yuri and Ramon making up the team of Tested, Austin Oliver and Marcus Lawrence as the Carolina Connection. And well, you see Marcus Lawrence, he was going after Dion Yuri for a second there. Those two have faced off in singles action here in Ammo Wrestling, with Marcus Lawrence getting the big victory. We'll see if those two's past comes into effect here tonight in any way, shape, or form. As now, oh, well, Marcus Lawrence has a table. I guess this is a self-made TLC match instead of a ladder match. Now Luke Franklin with an Alabama Slam powerbomb almost. Sit out Alabama Slam. And well, there's a lot of things that could go wrong in a TLC match. The innovators, of course, Jeff Hardy, Matt Hardy, Christian Edge, and the Dudley Boys, Bubba and Devon. Six of the greatest tag team wrestlers this world has ever seen. Probably six of the greatest wrestlers this world has ever seen. Now these six trying to replicate what they did in the Federation here in Ammo Wrestling. As Arthur Finch and Dion Urie go at it, and Luke Franklin and Ramon. Now Luke Franklin got him up. Just dropping him on the back. And well, Subway were the first official team in this match. But it was supposed to be Arthur Finch and Sebastian Ramos. Without that injury, I'm saying they're winning 9 times out of 10. They were the definite favorites going into this match if Sebastian Ramos had not have gotten hurt at the hands of Andy Garrett. Without that injury being sustained, I really do think Subway would have been the way to go if you were a betting person for this tag team title match. But with that being said, any six of these men, they could climb that ladder at any point. They could win this match at any point. It's just going to be a thing of luck. Who gets up there first? Who has the most time alone in the ring? Who takes the most damage? All that comes into play in a match like this. Well, all six of these men, you know they want to win. You know they want to be able to call themselves the first champions. Well, right now, all six of these men still in it. Still kind of in the opening stages of this contest. None of the three teams really able to definitively pull out in front so far. Well, it is chaos in the ring right now. All six men going at it. Ramon rolling out of the side of the ring. Might be the smartest strategy in this match as of right now. And Dion Urie goes out to join him. And so now it's just Subway versus Carolina Connection at the current moment. But Austin Oliver's out of the ring. Well, Dion Urie back in now, going straight after Luke Franklin. Made a beeline for him, but Luke was ready. And now Arthur Finch with the chair and the DDT on the chair. Now Luke Franklin with a ladder, setting it up underneath the tag team title. Is he going to look to go up and grab it? No. They're going to put a little bit more of a beating on Marcus Lawrence before he goes up. And a package pile driver, just dropping him right on his head and neck. Well, now Dion Urie kind of perplexed here. Looks like he's questioning if he should climb or go after Marcus Lawrence. And now that big kick combination was just hit by Arthur Finch. I missed most of it, but I saw that last big heel kick that he delivers. And now Dion Urie and Marcus Lawrence going to the outside. Lawrence able to take him with a big monkey flip. Now Arthur Finch with the ladder. Not for long, however. Now throwing Ramon to the outside of the ring, and now throwing Austin Oliver on the outside of the ring is Arthur Finch. And now Austin Oliver to the floor. Finch bringing Ramon back in. And now they both get hit by a ladder. Looks like Ramon was a little bit more hurt by it, though. And now Luke Franklin setting it up. Is he going to climb it? No, he is not. He's going to try and double team on Ramon. Well, no one's climbed a ladder yet. No one's made a poignant effort to go after that belt thus far. You got to expect one of these teams, they're going to have to. You don't want to wrestle all night. You don't want to take all your stamina away before you can even get the belts. Oh, now one of each member, or one member of each team in the ring right now. Arthur Finch, though, with a back suplex. Now Franklin picking up Austin Oliver. And what's he looking for here? Big rocker dropper. Haven't seen that one in a while. Now Arthur Finch trying to clear the ring almost. Now off the ropes he goes, and a penalty kick. And now Luke Franklin with a chair, just taking Austin Oliver to task. Now Ramon went to the top rope, but Franklin able to stop him with an arm drag. An arm drag off the top rope. And well, now Finch, he's got a kendo stick, and he's going after anyone that moves. Marcus Lawrence was trying to go after Luke Franklin, but Arthur Finch nailed him with that kendo stick right to the stomach. And now Marcus Lawrence got him up with a cord buster. Arthur Finch once again with the ladder, setting it up center of the ring. Austin Oliver gets sent out of the ring now. Deion Uri and Arthur Finch kind of fighting right now. Marcus Lawrence joining in on the fray. Finch trying to get him out of there. Now Ramon is on the ladder. He is on the top of the ladder, but Marcus Lawrence following him up there. Just some big stomach shots, trying to make sure he doesn't get that belt unhooked. As well, and now too much damage being delivered, and Ramon falling off the ladder. And well, now Deion Uri pushing the ladder down. It is pure chaos right now going on in this ring. As well, now someone's got to get that ladder back and get those titles. I think the next team to climb that ladder, and I could be mistaken, will be your World Tag Team Champions. And now Franklin setting up the ladder, but looking to do some more damage to Marcus Lawrence before he climbs. Went for something. Lawrence able to grab his leg and with a big clothesline send him to the ground. Arthur Finch now back in the ring. The snapmare for his troubles. And now a big half and half suplex by Arthur Finch. And now it is just Arthur Finch and Deion Uri who remain in the ring. Ramon and Marcus Lawrence, though, looking to join the fray. Ramon sending Marcus Lawrence right back outside the ring. And right now I definitely think one of the team of tested should be climbing that ladder trying to get those belts right now. There's only three people in the ring and two of them are tested. Well, now Ramon heeding my advice, going to the top of the ladder. Will he be able to pull those title belts down? He's got his hands on him, but Marcus Lawrence pushing the ladder out from under him, and a big power bomb. Marcus Lawrence bringing him down. He was hanging onto that ladder those title belts, I should say. He was hanging onto that title belt for dear life. Marcus Lawrence bringing him down with a big power bomb. Moan looking for something, but Marcus Lawrence. And now all six men back into the ring. And chaos ensues once more. Now out of the ring goes Marcus Lawrence, and out of the ring goes Luke Franklin. Austin Oliver looking for something here with a big Yosaka cutter. And Deion Uri with a DDT. So many big moves hit in this match, and we still don't have a winner yet. We still don't have a definitive. This is the person who's been on the offensive all match. We don't have one of those. All six of these men are being able to go after each other, take and deal damage. Now Finch being thrown out of the ring by Oliver, as well as, I believe that was Lawrence, was thrown out of the ring by Ramon. And well, now, right now, three men remain in the ring. Arthur Finch and Luke Franklin being two of them. Deion Urie getting back on the fray, though, with a super kick to Luke Franklin. And now Marcus Lawrence and Ramon fighting on the outside. Probably not the best strategy in a big ladder match like this right now. But it's the strategy they're employing, I guess. Now Finch sending Deion Urie off of the ring apron. Luke Franklin setting up that ladder. And he is climbing. And well, Austin Oliver looked for something but a crash and burn. And well, now Luke Franklin, he's got his hand on those titles. But Ramon able to stop him in another power bomb, this time by Austin Oliver. You got to think all six of these men, they're probably tired. They're probably worn out right now. Well, I can't say I blame them. You got to think something's got to give in this match. And now two men remain in the ring. Three men now. One member of each team. Marcus Lawrence of Carolina Connection. Arthur Finch of Subway. And Ramon of Tested. I think one of these men really need to be climbing that ladder right now, going after those tag team titles, directly going after the goal of this match right now. And Lawrence sent to the outside of the ring. Now Luke Franklin once again got the ladder. Is he going to set it up and climb it? He set it up. All he's got to do is climb and retrieve those belts. But no, Ramon grabbing him, but Franklin able to get out of it. Now the Carolina Connection entering the ring. Deion Urie as well. Urie pushes him off. Well, now Urie climbing up the ladder. He's got his hands on the titles. Ramon trying to fight off the herd of attackers going after him, but, well, he's getting close. Arthur Finch trying to knock him down. Well, he's trying to push the ladder down, but, yes, Deion Urie's got him. He's got the tag team titles and your inaugural tag team champions. The team of Tested, Deion Urie and Ramon. Probably the team I had the least faith in going into this match. And, well, they sure did prove me wrong, as they are now the first ever tag team champions. An incredible win, and one they will be celebrating all night long. You better believe it. And Tested are your tag team champions here in Ammo Wrestling. As we continue on with our night. They never leave. I got tests over my veins, cause that what I bleed. She drink a lot of the bourbon, like she from the street. We got control of the flows in her. We heard it your way went dry. And well, while this match might not be for the tag team titles, like the last one, it is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. It is the team of the Young Lions, DeAndre Campbell and William Reynolds. Tonight they face Kingdom, team of PK King and Sniper. Well, they're looking to do some good work here tonight. Face what they consider two of the worst men here in Ammo Wrestling. They're going to face them here tonight and try to get that big W that they're looking for. And well, like I said, facing the team of Kingdom, DK King and Sniper. All four of these men, they have history with each other. Well, you better believe this match is going to be implosive. It's going to be explosive. All four of these men want to get their hands on each other. We'll see who's able to get the victory here tonight. And maybe, just maybe, move their way up the tag team rankings to get a tag team title shot. And we'll match underway now. DK King and DeAndre Campbell, the two bitter rivals of this feud, starting it out. These two, they've been going at it since going the social distance where there was a number one contenders triple threat match. Well, DK King nor DeAndre Campbell were able to win that match. It was Goro Mori who then challenged the then world champion at going the social distance. And well, these two haven't really got along ever since then. As well, DeAndre Campbell bleeding already. As now going after PK King. And well, then Sniper gets involved as he started helping PK King. A couple weeks ago, PK King and DeAndre Campbell, they were facing off against each other in the main event. Well, Sniper, he came out, he was looking to help PK King. Well, DeAndre Campbell's new tag team partner, William Reynolds, who is getting pinned right now, only a one count. William Reynolds, he didn't like that. DeAndre Campbell had that backup plan in mind. And well, he was able to stop not only Sniper from attacking him, but also help DeAndre Campbell get the win over PK King. Now here comes Sniper. Sniper and Reynolds now in the ring. Kind of the allies to the bitter feud right now. And a big power slam by Reynolds. And he slams his head right into the canvas. We don't really know much about Sniper. We just know he's friends with PK King. That protective mask on his face. Don't know what he looks like, and well, I think he likes it that way. Campbell now in the ring, being tagged in, and now Sniper just some big elbows to the pectoral muscle. And a knee drop. Now going for some big shots. And a Pele kick ending it all. Now tagging in PK King. The cockiness and the arrogance of PK King cost him a chance at being the inaugural champion here in Ammo Wrestling. You got to believe he still hasn't forgot that. He wants that title more than anything. Well, right now it's DeAndre Campbell that's standing in his way of getting it. And we're now tagging in William Reynolds. I don't know much about Reynolds either. I know he's a fantastic performer. I know he's a good friend of DeAndre's, but other than that, I don't know anything about his wrestling style, about his personality. I haven't got a chance to talk to him much backstage. Well, now PK King pulling him to the center of the ring, but Reynolds able to fight his way out of it, and now tagging in DeAndre Campbell once again. Campbell looking for something, but PK King able to land a big knee, a boot, and a spinning heel kick. Sends DeAndre Campbell to the ground. Well, now he's got him up, and a neck breaker. And a float over suplex neck breaker. PK King having to use the ropes to stand up here. Now DeAndre staying on the attack, but PK King trying to get on the offensive with a DDT. And Now P.K. King taunting DeAndre Campbell. DDT once again by P.K. King. Reynolds now in the ring. And now an inverted Olympic slam. Second time we've seen that incredible maneuver here tonight. We're now tagging in Sniper. And a suplex by him now. And another big suplex. Sniper is just dominating right now. And a kick to the head. My goodness. And a knee drop. Sniper, just an incredibly powerful man, incredible strength, always on display by him. And now will Reynolds trying to drag himself back up to his feet. P.K. King not letting him. And a big sliced bread number two into the cover two. Only a two count there. I really thought that was going to be a three. Now P.K. King with some strikes of his own. And Sniper going after DeAndre Campbell with a DDT from the apron into the ring. Now Reynolds, clothesline there, pulling King to the center of the ring. And just slamming his face onto the mat. Picking him up. And he's got him up for a blue thunderbomb. If I was Reynolds, I would have gone for the pin there. Well, seems he's going for the pin now. Into the cover. One, two, only two. Sniper getting in the ring to break it up. Doesn't have to, though. P.K. King able to kick out on his own. Now Reynolds with a Russian leg sweep. Picking up King here. What's he looking for? Nothing as P.K. King drives his elbow right into the face, and now will Reynolds got him into a headlock here, trying just to keep the breathing at a minimum. But P.K. King able to break out of it as a back fist right to the face, and now a spinning neck breaker. Reynolds crawling, trying to get the tag, and he does. Now DeAndre Campbell back into the ring with a big pump kick. And just slams the arm. Picking up King now. Rolls him through. And a drop kick. Into the cover. One, two, no. Only a two count once again. P.K. King able to kick out, keeping this match alive. And now P.K. King with a backslide driver. Now King looking for something here. Throws him into the corner. Could be looking for the tag team maneuver there. But DeAndre Campbell able to get out of it. And now a big inverted Alabama slam. Sending P.K. King down on his face and a kick. And now the cover one, two. No, only two count once again. Not really sure if P.K. King kicked out or if Sniper broke up the pin. And will once again, P.K. King looking for that spinning heel kick once more. Now picking up Campbell. And a big cutter. A twisting cutter there. Is that enough to get the job done? Two, no, only two. Reynolds was ready to break up the pin if he had to. He was coming in the ring just in case. But now a DDT would make Jake Roberts jealous. And now Sniper tagging himself in. Not wanting P.K. King to take any more damage. And he nails a big Celtic cross there. Is that enough? No, only two. Referee's hand coming down for a three as DeAndre Campbell barely able to save this match. Looking for a super kick. Sniper now getting back on the attack as a stomp to the face. Now got him up. Just slams him right back down. Telling him to get up here. Now pulling him onto the ropes. Puts him on the second rope. What's he looking for here? Going outside of the ring and a knee to the face. Well, that's not the corner you want to be in if you're Sniper right now. Right there next to William Reynolds. Now, DeAndre throwing him into the corner. Well, William Reynolds taking a play out of Sniper's book, tagging himself in. And now he's got him up. Tire driver 97. Pulling him to the center of the ring, going for the cover now. One, only a one count. Sniper now back on his feet. Reynolds got him up. What's he looking for here? A big cradle shock into the cover. Is that enough? One, two, three, no. I really thought that cradle shock was enough to get the victory there. It looked like Sniper was down and out, and now just slamming his face into the ground one more time is William Reynolds. That comes as a big shock to me. I really thought that cradle shock, I thought it was enough to get the victory here, but Sniper has a little bit more in the tank. Now throwing Reynolds to the outside, picking him up. What's he looking for here? Big skull-crushing finale on the outside. Now throwing Sniper into the steel steps. I'm surprised DeAndre Campbell hasn't come down trying to help his partner here. Right now it doesn't look like he needs any help, I guess. Reynolds now showing off a little bit, trying to get the crowd on his side. Picking up Sniper. Now, some strikes exchanged by each man. A little bit of a reversal fest going on. Now both men getting back into the ring. Sniper with the head scissor, but Reynolds able to escape. Snapmare into the throwback. And Sniper rolling out of the ring, and William Reynolds getting right in the face of PK King. You know he didn't like that. PK King probably seething on the outside. You know he did not like Reynolds just getting in his face like that. Oh, now Sniper able to get the advantage. And PK King, he wants back in this match. As Sniper just slams Reynolds once again. Pulling him to the center of the ring. Could be going for the cover. Is that enough to get the job done? One, two, no. Once again, another two count here. In this incredible tag team match. And well, it's what put so many other men away before. It's the kill shot. Is it enough to put William Reynolds away this time? Yes, it is. Three. And the Kingdom Sniper and PK King able to get the job done here tonight. A little bit of bragging rights go to PK King and Sniper. An incredible tag team match. And well, all four of these men with an incredible, incredible match under their belts. In the end, only one team could win that kill shot. That'd be enough to put an elephant down. And tonight it was enough to put William Reynolds down. And your winners, PK King and Sniper. I hope this feud is settled now, at least for the time being. I have a feeling it isn't, but I'm really hoping it is. Because these men, they have such bright futures, and they've just been focusing all their attention on each other, and I'm ready to see what they can do outside of this rivalry, but ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back.
Shakedown.
And well now, ladies and gentlemen, we move into our second title match of the night. It is for the AMMO Women's Championship. It is to crown the inaugural AMMO Women's Champion. It is a fatal four-way match. So much is on the line here, not just the title, bragging rights, momentum, so much is on the line. Our first competitor, Carissa Salazar, able to qualify a couple weeks ago. And well, she's looking to compete in this match. And if nothing else proved, she belongs in this division. She's smart. We'll see if she's able to do that. Face, make it pop. Earthquake, girl, you my taste. Oh yeah. Ooh, she a lady boss, Machiavelli. Ooh, I'm an outlaw. You love it how I move you. You love it how I touch you, my one. When all is said and done, you will believe God is a woman. And I feel it. Well, if the theatrics of the entrance, if they aren't enough to prove to you that this woman means business, maybe her wrestling ability will here tonight. Maybe becoming the first ever women's champion will here tonight. It's Rosé. Rosé coming into this match with a lot of momentum, getting a win on the last episode of AMMO Wrestling. And well, she's looking to continue that wave of momentum in probably the biggest match of her career thus far, at least here in AMMO Wrestling. Women's title on the line, such an incredible opportunity. We'll see if she's able to capitalize on it here tonight. And well, the third competitor in this match, she won the inaugural women's match at Going the Social Distance, beating Carissa Salazar, as well as Lydia Madison. Madison taking the pin in that match. Well, tonight, just like that match, there can only be one winner. There will be three losers here tonight. We'll see if Nikita B is able to come out on top in this multi-woman match and earn herself a women's title. And recorded, but your edge up all I'm showing. I keep my niggas private, so it's AP all I'm showing. Beefing with you bitches really getting kind of boring. If it ain't about the money, then you know. Well, our fourth and final competitor, it is Courtney. Courtney able to get the victory over Rosé on the last episode of Ammo Wrestling. Big momentum game for her. And we'll see if she's able to stay in the head of Rosé after getting that victory in the last episode of Ammo. Well, Courtney, she's probably my favorite in this match behind Nikita B. We'll see what she can do in this high-stakes, high-reward match. Starting in just a moment. And well, there you see the Ammo Women's Championship. An incredible belt forged of pure gold. And only one of these women, only one can have it for right now. As this match is underway, a fatal four-way match to determine who becomes the first ever champion of our women's division. Our women's division, frankly new. We don't know what kind of talent lies underneath the surface. Haven't really explored it that much. Right now, we just know these four women, at least at this very moment, they are the best, at least in win-loss record and opportunities given. There could be a woman out there in Ammo Wrestling world, but they haven't got the same opportunity just yet. They haven't been able to showcase their abilities just yet. And well, I'm very excited for this women's division. I'm excited to see what comes of this women's division and who becomes really the standout performer in this division and how it grows and models the shape of Ammo Wrestling. It should be an incredible ride. And well, you see Nikita B and Courtney going at it. Like I said, match from last episode of Ammo, Courtney getting the victory. Gotta think Rosé might want some vengeance for the embarrassment of defeat that she suffered from Courtney. Nikita B and Carissa Salazar going at it as well. Two competitors at our first ever women's match at going the social distance. They meet again, but this time it's for the women's championship. And well, now Rosé on the top rope. What is she looking for here? Waiting for Courtney to get up as a blockbuster off the top rope. As well, now Carissa Salazar getting back into the ring, joining Courtney and Rosé. Nikita B still on the outside, but Carissa Salazar seeing her get up, goes right back on the attack. And now Nikita B and Carissa Salazar going at it on the outside while Rosé and Courtney going at it on the inside, but commentators curse, they roll right onto the outside. All four of these women brawling here on the outside. Well, now we go back into the ring with Nikita B and Courtney. They are just taking this fight all over the arena. All in the name of winning the women's title. Now Nikita B looking for something on Salazar. Like a fisherman suplex right there. Incredible maneuver. Now Rosé, what's she looking for here? A big knee right to the face. Going for the cover. Is that enough? No one there to break it up. 3-0. Just barely a 2 count. I really thought that might have been a 3. Now off the top rope with the elbow.
And a sling blade by Courtney now, and a drop kick. Both pairs of women, they've been fighting the entire time. They haven't really taken their eyes off of the other. And well, now Courtney going for the cover, only a two count though. Nikita B with some big knees of her own. It has been a fight between Rose and Courtney, as well as Nikita B and Carissa Salazar this entire time. Neither of the four have looked at another competitor the way they're looking at their dance partner right now. As Courtney nails a big cross body after some nice drop kicks. And well, now Nikita B going in for the cover. Just barely not able to get the three count. Rose throwing Courtney to the outside. And now Nikita B just planting her with a Michinoku driver. Planting Salazar. Salazar rolling to the outside. Now once again, all four women on the outside. Most dangerous part of the arena. So many elements to hurt and break bones. Brain damage, concussions. So much stuff on the outside of the ring that can cause any one of those injuries and more. And well, now Salazar, she's got her up with a kick to the head. Now going in for the cover. One, two, no. Only a one count for Nikita B there. Very surprising seeing that her and Carissa have been fighting this entire time, and well, it's been a pretty even affair, but Nikita B not showing any weakness there, kicking out at one. But now Salazar going up to the top rope. And she's looking for a coup de grace. A big double foot stomp off the top rope. Is that enough to put her away? Yes, it is. No. Yes, it is. And Nikita B getting eliminated. She is the first elimination in this four-way dance. Probably the favorite going into this match, I would say. Had an incredible hot streak. And now those dreams of being the women's champion, those are crushed. One of these three women will be the women's champion. It will either be Courtney, Carissa Salazar, Rose. And well, the fighting doesn't stop just because there's an elimination as Nikita B exits the arena. Now Courtney stalking Rose, looking for something here. A twisting DDT into the cover. Is that enough? One, two, three. And it is down to Carissa Salazar and Courtney, who will be able to walk out of Ammo Wrestling, kill the lights, as the first ever women's champion. Courtney blocking the kick and a double foot stomp. Well, she's going to the corner. She's looking for something here. A big punt kick. A punt kick knocking out Carissa Salazar. And I think that's the kill shot. That's going to be enough to get her the women's title. Yes, it is. And Courtney is your women's champion. Your first ever Ammo women's champion. Earning that right with that devastating punt kick. Such an incredible maneuver, such a dangerous maneuver. Well, after you get hit with it, you see the effects. Carissa Salazar not able to recover in time. Getting counted for the three. You see some of the incredible moves that even I missed. And well, tonight she gets to celebrate, but tomorrow is another day with another challenger, and you can guarantee that. But for tonight at least, Courtney can celebrate, and she can say she is the women's champion. What an incredible match with an incredible winner for an incredible division. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you know what time it is. It's my favorite time of the night. It is main event time. And it is for the AMMO World Championship. It is the conclusion of this wonderful night of wrestling. And it isn't the conclusion for someone's title reign. And it is... And is it the beginning of someone else's? It's going to be an incredible main event. It's going to be Goro Mori, who you see coming to the ring right now. It's going to be BT Bobby Mann. And it's going to be the world champion, Malcolm Bates, going one-on-one to decide who is the best that AMMO has to offer. Either man could definitely win. So it's going to come down to pure luck, who's in the right place at the right time, and who has the most damage done. We'll see if Goro Mori will be able to be that lucky man in the right place at the right time. But he's got two men standing in his way. And one of them's coming to the ring right now. It is BT Bobby Mann. The BT stands for Bloodthirsty. And after his weeks of attacks and matches here on AMMO Wrestling, you can tell he is bloodthirsty. He is out to hurt. And well, what better way to hurt than with two opponents instead of one? Goro Mori and BT facing off on the last episode in the main event of AMMO Wrestling. Incredible match. In the end, BT was able to walk away with the victory with his hand held high. Well, that was his only match in AMMO Wrestling thus far, but he finds himself in an incredible position as he is in the world title match and only his second match here in AMMO Wrestling. Well, we'll see if he's able to prove all the doubters wrong here tonight and say that he is the best, even if he hasn't been here the longest of anyone in this match. And well, our final competitor, it can't be a world championship match without the world champion. And here he comes down to the ring, strutting like the cocky, arrogant man he is. Ladies and gentlemen, Malcolm Bates won that title just a few short weeks ago, beating the inaugural champ. Then he defended it against Goro Mori the next week. He was able to get the victory, but key thing is, right after that world title match where Malcolm Bates won the title to begin with, Goro Mori came out to congratulate him, but Malcolm Bates is having none of that, punched him right in the face with some brass knucks. But on the last episode, after BT Bobby got the victory over Goro, Malcolm Malcolm Bates came out, shaked his hand, looked nice and cheerful, but then he attacked Bobby as well, leading to this triple threat match and leading this world title defense. And well, this match, it is underway. Malcolm Bates going right after BT Bobby. And now Bobby with a big suplex. And well, I've got to count it interesting. Talking to BT earlier, he really doesn't care about the belt. He thinks he'll have plenty of opportunities to win the world title in the future. Like I said, this is only his second match in AMA Wrestling. Well, he's not too concerned about winning that title immediately. That makes him far more dangerous, in my opinion. What's more dangerous than someone who has nothing to lose but everything to gain? They already have nothing, so if they walk away with what they had, they're just even. So BT Bobby, you got to think he's going to take some chances in this match. He's going to go after both of these men a little bit more aggressively. When right now you're seeing that as he's going after Malcolm Bates. BT there with a face buster. Now Goro getting on the attack. Him and BT, they've had an incredible rivalry up to this point. And well, tonight they're looking to settle the score of who's the better man and who deserves the world title. All three of these men just really not getting along thus far in AMA Wrestling. And well, now Malcolm Bates has got him up with a gourd buster. What comes up must come down, and Goro Mori came down with a thud. Malcolm pulling him to the center of the ring. What's he looking for here? A big bullplex. Just throwing him over the shoulder and now taking some time to spout off to the fans. You know that's his favorite thing, talking the talk. But you best believe he's been able to walk the walk thus far in AMA Wrestling. He wouldn't be the world champion if he couldn't. Now Goro Mori going in for the cover. One, BT Bobby breaking it up. Goro now with a neck breaker. BT able to duck out of the way of that clothesline and delivers one of his own. Now just going after the head of Goro Mori. Those big punches, we saw him in the last encounter between the two. BT, like I said, able to get the victory in that match. At one point in the match between Goro Mori and Malcolm Bates. Well, BT hit this move that he's about to hit. Here, the bloodshot. He hit that move three times on Goro Mori to help Malcolm Bates get the victory. Well, it was enough on that night, but Goro Mori able to break the cover up on Malcolm Bates. We might have had a new world champion, and this match might have been very lackluster, very short, if Goro Mori wasn't there to break it up. And now BT just going after him with a Fez press and some punches raining down. Well, now Malcolm Bates off the ropes with another shoulder tackle. Once again, now thrown out of the ring, but able to catch his footing. Going to the top rope. What's he looking for here? A double axe handle off the top rope. Now it's just him and Goro Mori as that big knee to the face, the thing that won him the world championship. Is there enough to retain it? One, two, no. Goro Mori able to kick out. Well, now Goro looking for a big boot, but Malcolm got him up with a title taker. His finishing maneuver, the title taker. Is it a title keeper? No. Only a two count. And Goro Mori right back up, trying to get some offense going. I think he's been the least on the offensive thus far. Oh, now Malcolm Bates. Oh, he went to use those brass knucks, but Bobby able to move out of the way. Now Goro Mori with a suplex. Now into the cover.
Referee in position. Malcolm Bates breaking it up. But now Goromori, almost like a Dream Street, but a rolling Dream Street. An incredible maneuver. And now Goromori returning the favor from earlier in the match. And well, now Bobby BT's got him up again. Bloodshot once more. That incredible maneuver. That incredibly insightful maneuver. Now going for the cover. One, two, three, no. Barely a three count. Barely a two count, I should say. Almost a three count. Now Goromori trying to pick up Bobby here, but BT able to get out of the way. Malcolm Bates now throwing him into the corner. Now focusing his attack on Goromori with a big slam and now looking for something else. Got his arm wrapped. He's going for something, but Goromori able to get out of it. And then Malcolm Bates looking for something else, but Goromori once again able to get out of it. And now slamming. Malcolm Bates is Goromori. Malcolm Bates rolls out of the ring, and BT Bobby now with a brain buster. Now just cranking on the neck. Going for the cover again. One, two, no. And what we saw on the official Ammo Twitter page, if Malcolm Bates is to not win this match, he is guaranteed an automatic rematch at the Magnificent 16. You got to think that's a big reliever for him. Maybe he wouldn't be taking this as serious because of that. And we're now once again with the bloodshot. And we're now Goromori right back up. BT went for the cover, but Goromori able to catch him. And we're now Goromori looking for something here. Elbow to the side of the head, falling onto the ropes. Now Goro leapfrogs him once again, and a big back elbow. Now it's just Malcolm and Goro in the ring. Goro's calling for him to get up here. Is he looking for that big fist wake? No, he's not. But he does hit that big face buster, and I think that's enough to get the job done. Yes, it is, and we have a new world champion here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our second new world champion in just a month, and his name is Goromori. But like I said just a moment ago, Malcolm Bates, he has that automatic rematch clause at the Magnificent 16 event, and you know he's going to use it. You know he's going to abuse it. So it will be Goromori. Right now, at least, it'll just be Goromori and Malcolm Bates going at it at Magnificent 16. But at least for tonight, Goromori gets to call himself the champion. And he is the Ammo champion. And he is the champion of the world. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this has been an incredible night of action. And that is all the time we have for you here tonight. What an incredible match. And what an incredible new champion. We'll see you next time.